Praise the Lord, everyone. Once again, I would like to take this opportunity to meet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As we are learning, we are meditating a lot of things, and we are understanding the choices, what we are supposed to take and leave in our daily life. And many things we are understanding and many aspects we are discussing. I believe this is the pure inspiration of God, and God is inspiring me with these subjects. You might be knowing these subjects, you might be knowing these Bible verses, these passages, but I feel this is a kind of revision what we are doing, so that in these last days, in these end times, we'll prepare ourselves in such a way that even a small thing shall not be left over. So, my dear brothers and sisters, once again, I want to speak on this subject called choices we make. What choices are we making? What kind of choices will lead us to God? If you see in Bible, we see there are many characters, many people who were chosen by God, who were in the will of God. But regarding some people, God says, I hate somebody and I love somebody. So what does it mean? If you see, if you compare these things to our spiritual life, even there are certain things in our life which God may hate or which God is not willing in that subject. Whereas in certain aspects, God is more concerned in our life. So let us understand one thing, like if you see Romans chapter 9 from verse 10 to 13, there are certain verses here. It says like, and not only that, but these two, Rebekah conceived two sons under exactly the same circumstances by our forefather Isaac. And the children were yet unborn and had so far done nothing either good or evil. Even so, in order further to carry out God's purpose of selection, which depends not on works or what men can do, but on him who calls them. It was said to her that the elder son should serve the younger son. And in verse 13 it says like, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. What does this mean? If you see, why God is hating Esau and why God is loving Jacob? What is the resemblance here we are understanding? We need to understand, we ought to understand these things, my dear brothers and sisters. If you compare this into our spiritual life, what God hates and what God loves. If you understand this scripture as a New Testament Christian, we can see here what Paul is writing here. It says like verse 13, verse 12, the elder should serve the younger. Who is elder? If you compare in our life, we have three things in us. One is body, soul, and spirit. Body, soul, and spirit are the parts for the human being. But if you see the seniority or experience, we have body, we have soul from the birth itself. But when it comes to spiritual aspects and the spirit of God, spirit is in you when you believed our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as a personal Savior. So this means the body and soul, as I told you and I am telling you again, body is like a puppet in the hands of soul. So we'll keep body apart and we'll talk about soul. Soul is something which always controls body, and soul is in us from the beginning. But when you accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, or when we confessed our sins and accepted Jesus as our personal Savior, then the Spirit of God has come into our life. But according to God's will, our spirit must dominate our soulish desires. So in this verse, if you compare, it says like, the elder should serve the younger. So elder means our soul. Younger means our spirit. Spirit which is from God, the Holy Spirit. So this body and the body desires or the soulish desires must be suppressed, and the spiritual aspects in our life should be increased and also developed, flourished in our daily life. If that is not happening, we will end up in a wrong choice. That is the reason, if you see Galatians chapter 5, it says like, the works of the flesh. The works of the flesh, in which God is not at all delighted, and God is not at all impressed. And it says like, I will read this scripture for you. It says like, now the doings of the flesh are clear. They are immorality, impurity, indecency, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, anger, selfishness, divisions, party spirit, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and the like. I warn you beforehand, just as I did previously, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. So, and in the verses which are below, verses 22 and 23, it says like, the fruits of Holy Spirit. So God is clearly intending and demonstrating us that the soulish desires must die. How they will die? There are a lot of ways. So it is our choice whether you behave in the soulish manner or you behave in the spiritual manner. So my dear brothers and sisters, today I want to tell you one thing. What kind of choices we are making in our daily life? Even 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 31 says that even if you eat, drink, and whatever you do, it must glorify God. So the motives behind our every work are determined by the ways we are doing. So I want to tell you one thing today. This might look something strange to you, but why God has hated Esau and loved Jacob? It is the purpose and plan of God from the beginning. Before they were born, the scripture says that. But in this context, if you understand, God always gets impressed only with your spiritual aspects, not with your soulish desires and soulish acts and works of the flesh. So today, what kind of choice we are taking? In our daily life, what kind of choices we are desiring? Because soul and spirit always have a fight, a continuous, constant fight in our spiritual life. Soul always wants you to be away from the spiritual aspects, and your spirit, which is dwelling in you from the Holy Spirit God, it is always constantly trying you to be away from the soulish desires. So, what kind of choices we are making? If your choice is towards the Spirit of God, then your acts will be in spirit. If the choice is soulish and you love to be in the soulish desires, your acts will be soulish only. So this is your choice, which you need to take, which will really change your life and your lifestyle. So I hope you are understanding what I am talking about. So spirit is a younger one, which came into us. The Spirit of God came into us, not from the birth, but when you are saved, when you receive the salvation. But the soul is in you from your birth. But the spirit belongs to God, and soul will be there only till you are in this earth, on this earth. So my dear friends, let us take a choice. Let us understand it. And let us examine ourselves. What kind of choices we are making? What kind of interests we have? What kind of desires we have? Are they soulish or they are in spirit? So let us ask God and let us cleanse ourselves if it is soulish, because God doesn't like the soulish things. Because Galatians 5, chapter 20, 5 and verse 21 says like this: just as I did previously, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. So it is very clear that those who want to live in this soulish and body desires, they will not inherit the kingdom of God. So what is your choice? What kind of future you require? You take a call and you can take a decision. Thank you.